Him. Get up. I want you out. Now.
I don't know how. I don't know what I was afraid of.
I mean, can you believe it? Now she's upstairs using up all of our hot water.
Frankie, shouldn't you be getting dressed? You're going to be late for the bean.
I am going to swing for Esther. I mean, as if we haven't got enough to contend with in this house at the moment, as it is. What are we going to do?
Look, it must have been the same person that rang last night. You sure you didn't recognise the voice?
It was a woman, but it was too muffled. We're going to jail, both of us. And I can't, Darren, there's Oscar and Charlie.
I won't let that happen.
You've read this note, right? Someone knows what you did.
Yeah, and I'll sort it.
How? You've hidden a dead body, and I'm an accessory. How is any of this ever going to be sorted?
You think you can win me?
Betsy.
How are you two doing here?
When you called us back yesterday, we need to speak to you. I know that we thought it was all over, but last night it was a phone call.
From who?
The same person who sent this. Someone does know about Patrick.
Who would do this? I don't know, but we have to pay them. We can't risk all of us going to prison.
Well, won't they just come back asking for more?
Maybe, but what choice have we got?
Come with me.
Jaded love.
Past.
Maxine will be here. She'll have the money.
Why do they want to meet us anyway? Why don't they just get us to dump it?
Because whoever it is a psycho and they want to see us cacking our pants.
But how do they know we won't go to the police?
What, and land ourselves in it? Look, Nancy, I don't regret helping Maxine get rid of the body.
What if all of this comes out? I can't lose Oscar. Charlie's been through enough recently. Darren, I'm scared.
I won't let anything happen to you. Or the kids. I promise.
I swear.
I told you she wouldn't turn up, didn't I?
There must be something up with Minnie. Maxine wouldn't let us down like this.
Well, she just has. I mean, what are we going to do, Darren?
I'm going to go to the police. We're going to tell them it was all me and leave you and Maxine out of it.
No, no, you can't. I mean, the boys need you. I need you.
Well, what choice have we got? You know, I can't spend my life on the run from someone. And isn't it better one of us goes to prison than both of us? Maxine, where have you been? I've been trying to get a hold of you all.
Sorry. Just trust me when I say you've got nothing to worry about anymore.
What are you on about? What about the money? I mean, do you know who it was?
I'm sorting it. There'll be no more blackmail.
It's over with, Darren.
Maxine. Maxine.
She can't just leave us hanging like that.
Maxine said she'd sort it.
Just in time. We're popping down the chippy for tea. My treat.
What happened in here since we left? It was like World War III this morning.
It's all water under the bridge. Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves, but there's nothing like a battered sausage for burying the hatchet.
Me and Kim are back together.
Oh, that's great news.
Thanks for your support, Darren. What's that? Is it a love letter from the milkman? I've seen him giving Frankie the eye.
I think that's just one of our friends messing around.
What's wrong?
It's from Lindsay.
What?
This is Lindsay's handwriting.